UKOG's been providing some feedback today from drilling at their Broadford Bridge well in West Sussex. To talk through the details, I've got with me on Skype the independent oil and gas analyst, Barney Gray. Barney, good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Good afternoon. Hi, Andrew.
Barney, of course, signs of gas, UKOG have said, at Broadford Bridge. The big prize here, of course, is oil. They're reporting gas, but that doesn't necessarily equate to the presence of oil, does it?
Not necessarily. I mean, the overlying encouragement I'd take from this is that straight away you're seeing hydrocarbon shows from the first Kimmeridge layer that the well is intersecting. Remember, you've got four more. This is just the first one that they've entered, and they're showing it's showing wet gas. Now, obviously, this needs to go away for core testing, but all I could really say in this part of the world that's a pretty good encouraging start. You've got four more layers to, well, you've got the first one to continue drilling through, and then three more. So hydrocarbon shows from the first off. I think that's pretty good encouraging news. So let's see what the other three deliver as well.
So pretty encouraging news there. I mean, what would positive results from this well mean more broadly for the Weald Basin?
Well, that's going to be one of the most important factors here. This is a very well documented well. The information that they've been given during and before the actual drilling activities has been first class, really. You can really see what the company are doing. It's very transparent. And I think for very good reason, in that they want, I think this well is going to be very much a litmus test for how the whole play pans out. Horse Hill and Broadford Bridge are not, it's not a step out. They're not necessarily that close together. So really, if this one works as well as they're hoping, you are going to see very much a justification of the entire play in the Weald Basin. So that's going to be very exciting when you see the full results of that.
So as you say there, it's a completely different license. In terms of the locality, just remind us where it fits into to the likes of Horse Hill, Brockham and the like.
Yeah, well, if you had the benefit of seeing a map of this, you can see that Horse Hill is located very close to Brockham, and also the upcoming Homewood well. I don't have a date for that one, but they're in a little triangle, really, very close, literally a few kilometres from each other. Broadford Bridge is a little further down to the southwest. So it's a slightly different area. It's as such, I wouldn't call it a step out well, but you really would expect to see the same kind of formations that you saw on Horse Hill. You can make a lot of interpretations as what's between that. You know, this is a large play, and it takes up a large aerial extent.
And interestingly, Barney, well, interestingly for UKOG, I suppose they've got a 100% interest in this.
Well, that is very interesting, we've noted that Horse Hill was very much a syndicate effort. There was a number of companies involved. There was a great deal of trading in and out of interests, certainly while there was a lot of oil price instability a few years ago. UKOG have got 100% in this. That just goes to show that they are probably highly confident of the outcome of this, and they'd like to get the benefit of the upside. So, you know, that it's very much a different strategy from UKOG in that they take all of the upside.
So exciting times here, Barney, for the Weald Basin. What are the next big events? What can we look out for as far as the Weald Basin and developments there are concerned?
Well, you can probably have a great deal of visibility on the likelihood of activity in this area. Obviously, you've got probably several more updates to come from Broadford Bridge. I don't doubt that there'll be that'll accelerate as they start to hit the additional Kimmeridge intervals. The Brockham well, the Angus Energy operated Brockham well, there's been a bit of a hiatus in that at the local council level, but when results start coming out from that, when they've sorted out that little hiatus, again, you're looking at some potentially very interesting technical details coming out, more akin to the Horse Hill well. And it hasn't got a spud date yet, but the Europa-operated Homewood well, which is one that I'm looking forward to seeing being drilled. Possibly, it's certainly slated for the second half of this year, but, you know, it may be 6 months away. But again, you're looking at another well, which is going to go some way to really confirming that this play in the Weald Basin, it really could be as exciting as people are thinking.
Barney, appreciate that. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you. Thanks, Andrew.